guys, welcome back to Andrew Faithful channel, and today we're gonna have a new unit showcase. Yeah, and the unit we are going to showcase is the new Dark Longinus, who just recently obtained her weapon, yeah, her special weapon for her master ability, yeah. And her master ability is animation, is really, really a cool one, yeah, really, really a cool one. So, let's go first with this unit. Well, this is the one I found, one the most complete unit here, although her SP is not that high, yeah. But we can see later in the Alchemist DB page, web page, what kind of stats she could gain on max out level 91 and with the perfect equipment, okay? So first of all, her leader skill. Her leader skill, it gives all warrior units HP plus 50%, piercing damage plus 20%, and initial damage against Eldritch monsters plus 30%, okay? When you raise up, when you max out the ship seal, the last seal, the part that changes in this leader, skills is this one, yeah. The piercing damage which is just transformed into all attack, okay? All attack type, okay? So now her leader skill is giving all warrior units HP plus 50%, more damage against Eldritch plus 30%, and the new thing here is that she gives all the attack type plus 20%, okay, for warrior units. Now let's look at her ability in her main job as a Dark Spear Princess, maybe if I'm not wrong about that, but okay. So let's see first. The first skill in the main set. The first one is a movement skill, which gives her for one turn 2x of physical attack and physical defense. So she's more stronger, but also more strong. So she can deal a lot of damage, while at the same time she can resist a ton of damage during one turn. Yeah. Max movement 4 squares where the unit initially was, and the high difference of movement is 2 floors. Okay. The second skill is a skill that applied on all the map. Okay. In all the map, all the units that are in the map will get more accuracy rate and also more magical defense. So this is a very good skill if you want to use it for units who has not much of a dexterity, yeah. Or when the enemies there has a little bit, has a little high of evasion rate, yeah. So this skill is a very good thing to use against those kind of enemies such as Warinau, yeah. And also the magical defense is a very good part because the units there can resist more magical damage against magical units. So it is applied on all the map, and by that reason it ignores all high difference, okay? The third skill is an attack type skill, which is piercing damage, or elemental attack, which ignores enemies' defenses. It has critical chance, it is boosted against fire type units, and it can attack almost 4 enemies in the same line. Range 4, it is ensure 1 square, yeah, and high defense 2 floors. So this skill, as I have said earlier before, it can hit almost 4 enemies in the same line, almost, okay? The last skill in the main set, this is the most powerful one she has, is also a range type skill, piercing damage, war element skill also, yeah, which ignores enemies' defenses, has critical chance, and when the more enemies are in the area, in this skill's areas of effect, it has even more power. Range 3 is a small cross shape and high defense 3 floors. From the basic set, the first one is a trident shape, it has trident shape, high defense 2 floors, range 2, in which is a war element, is piercing damage type attack, and it causes paralysis to all the enemies that this skill hits. Yeah, also has critical chance. The second one, it gives her for only once guts, okay? Guts for only once, okay? So she can survive one mortal attack, which normally could kill her, okay? And the last skill, it is applied using the unit as the center, For 3 turns, he keeps all this critical rate up, and for Dark Longinus herself, he increases max HP buff, and also the additional HP she gets by using this skill, it is recovered completely, okay? It has diamond shape, diameter 5 squares, and high defense 2 flocks. From the reaction ability, normally the reaction ability is as the same as any other Black Killer unit from the collaboration, like Dark Longinus or Dark Levitain, whose is just returning or, well, reflecting the damage received from enemies, okay? 50% of it, okay? But the here the friend has the friend here uses the one from the Haniel ancient bow of sacred lancer, okay? So this skill, it keeps it can activate it before she receives an attack. Before receiving any attack, she can counter the enemy, okay? And it can also be activated when the enemy uses skills against her. Range 4, range 2, and high defense 2 flows. From the passive abilities, the first one from her main job as a Dark Spear Princess, it gives her more attack and more physical attack and more physical defense. Okay, so that's why her physical defense is really, really high. And the last one, normally it gives all the unit more HP, more physical attack, and more evasion rating against slash damage. But when you raise, when you max out the bear seal, that is the slot seal, you can get additional piercing damage up buff, okay? From this passive ability, okay? So in total, it gives more HP, more physical attack, more piercing damage, and more evasion rate against slash damage. So it's a good passive skill if you want to raise up, well, max out the bear seal if you have her at level 91, okay? Okay guys, so here, as I have promised before, this is a level 91 max out long. Yeah, max out level 91 long. We have 3 seals max out, yeah. The equipment I suggest including here, and also the 3 master level job, okay? Jobs here. So first, let's look at her stats. Well, with this equipment I have choose, she will have the best power efficiency, okay? So here it looks, HP 4.4k is really, really high HP, yeah. Physical attack 800 is really high also. Physical defense 858, this is an extremely high physical defense, guys. With this physical defense, you can resist almost anything, and it's even higher than Chloe's and also Paladins from Atrian Odyssey's collaboration unit, okay? Magical defense 288 is still a little bit lower than the normal one, because the normal ones will get over 300, but 288 is still low, so she can receive a little bit of damage from thunder from magical units, especially if it is a thunder unit. Yeah, a very powerful thunder unit could leave her in a semi critical state, not that really a critical state, but she can stay in a perilous situation, yeah, maybe. Dexterity 347 is still a little bit low for a level 91 unit, because she can fail with units who has a little bit of evasion rate passive, yeah, increase. Agility 132 is low, it's really, really slow. Not that slow, but she's still a little bit slower than the normal for a level 91. So she can really act very fast. So she's geared almost for tanking enemies' attacks. Okay, critical 437 is a really high critical. Yeah, luck 184 is still a little bit low. Yeah, it's a lower luck, so she can receive almost any critical. Jewels 210 is a bit higher. Yeah, because of this equipment. Yeah. Initial Jewels 52, so she can do her most powerful skill right from the first turn, yeah, in the Colosseum. Healing 100%, movement 4, jump 2, is still the average one from any unit, yeah. So the overall stats with this equip: hit rate plus 5%, evasion rate plus 15%. You will obtain per normal attack 32, so it's the normal one. If it is a critical, you will receive almost 50. Per attack plus 20%, slash evasion rate plus 40% is high. Yeah, for this 40% is high. So slash units cannot hit this unit very easily, such as Dark Tiefling. Yeah, or any slash unit. Yeah. Single target attack plus 10%. So the unit has a little bit of more single target attack because of this gear. Yeah, this one from Full Metal Alchemist, it gives single target attack plus 10%. Okay, that's why she has this single target attack. Without it, well, let's see how other combinations of armor we can equip on this unit. Now let's look at this weapon equipment combination. Yeah, this is the normal one you should equip with any unit. Yeah, it gives the units a little bit less of physical attack and physical defense, so reducing her power and also her resistance, but increasing a little bit of HP and also her agility. Also her dexterity will get increased. 398 is a really good dex, so this is a very good dex for her. For a level 91 unit, HP also, she has a very good HP. Yeah, and the agility 143, and now this agility is still the average one for any level 91 unit, so she wouldn't have so much trouble acting here and then in any mission. Yeah. And this all stats are still the same, but without the single target attack, because the Full Metal Alchemist special weapon is not equipped with her. Okay. So with another combination here, we can raise more her physical attack during this. While equipping this black ring, we can upgrade her physical attack to 816. Yeah, 816, so it will be a little bit more powerful than the one before with Full Metal Alchemist weapon, but her agility will get decreased and also her dex. Yeah, and we also need her max G-Will capacity, which is normally 180. This is a little bit lower for a Black Killer unit. Yeah. Now if we equip here with this one, this is the mana seed, the rainbow mana seed, then the stats will get something like this. The dexterity will be still the same, the physical attack, physical defense will be still the same, the HP will be still the same, but her agility will be a little bit will get more agility. Yeah, 143, so she can act a little bit more faster. Yeah. And when we cook the vision gear from the special vision gear from the collaboration, yeah, we can get these stats. This is the stats that are in the battle, base stats while in battle, without little skill modifications. Yeah. So her speed will be 4700. Yeah. 4.7k. Physical attack 842. Physical defense 828. Magical defense 276. Dexterity 395, agility 158, critical 485, luck 232, G-Will's max G-Will capacity 180. So this will be a bit good. Yeah, it's a little bit good. If you want her to have more resistance, then you can, instead of using this, you can use this one. Yeah. With using this skill in this Longinus, you can get a little bit of more HP. Yeah, 500. Yeah, 5000. If we and equip this vision gear, then her basic stats will get it like this: 5000, 5.3k. It's a really insane HP. Yeah, she is now one of the most resistant units from the collaboration with BOTK. Yeah, Phantom of the Kill. But in exchange for gaining more resistance in HP, she will lose her power. Very high power loss. Okay, so her physical attack will get 685 and physical defense 600, so she will be less resistance into resisting enemies attacks, and also she will have more trouble killing the units because her power is not as high as before. 685 against 800 is a great difference. Yeah, in my opinion, it's a great difference. So if you want to have her more resistance during battle, especially in long-term battles, then you should equip this ability to her. If not, if you want to kill more faster enemies, then you should equip this one. Yeah, this is the second one here. And you should get more power and also more defense, physical defense. Mm-hmm. But I think her HP will be as good as any level 9 one unit. 4,500 is high. Yeah, really, really high. Okay guys, so that's all for today's video for now. Thank you for watching, see you next time, and remember to subscribe if you haven't. And if you have already subscribed, activate the chime if you want to receive more notifications when YouTube when I upload more videos. So that's all for today's video for now guys, thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.